What do your phone, the sun, the stove, far-off black holes, and the palm of your hands all have in common? Radiation, baby. It's everywhere. Up and at 'em, friends. Trace here, emitting and absorbing radiation at your eyeballs for D News. When I say radiation, though, most people do this. But to be honest, radiation on its own isn't necessarily harmful. The term radiation is super broad. Gamma rays shooting out of stars is radiation. Heat coming off the pavement on a hot day, that's radiation too. And the radio waves picked up and emitted by cell phones, radio station, and Wi-Fi networks are all also radiation. Even the light you're seeing on this screen right now is radiation. The thing is, even though radio, microwave, visible, and infrared are technically radiation, when we say that word, most people think of dangerous high-energy particles called ionizing radiation. That includes ultraviolet, X-rays, or gamma rays, which makes sense, but what can this stuff do when it hits your body? In 1927 in the journal Science, Hermann Muller published a paper showing the ionizing radiation of X-rays damaged the genes of fruit flies. He later won a Nobel Prize for that. Ionizing radiation is a high-energy radiation. It's got lots of energy in it. When this high-energy particle or wave hits an atom, the atom absorbs that energy, causing the weakest electron to pop off. This creates a charged atom called an ion. Do that enough, and all that high energy can cause chemical changes in our tissue, which is also made of atoms. If ionizing radiation affects too many cells at once, or we absorb a bunch over time, that's when we risk sickness, radiation poisoning, or eventually cancer. That happens when the radiation changes how things fit together. It might knock off bits of our DNA, mess with its structure, or at worst, break one or both strands of the DNA double helix. That alone isn't damaging, but sometimes the body makes mistakes when repairing that damage, causing more widespread issues. But chances are, you'll never have to worry too much about how much radiation you're being exposed to. Radiation dosage is measured in sieverts. One sievert in a short time can cause radiation sickness, and 10 can kill, but because we'd never really encounter a full sievert, scientists usually talk in millisieverts. Every year, just living on Earth exposes us to 2.4 millisieverts in natural background radiation. It's fine. A chest X-ray, for example, is about 6.8 millisieverts. So while one X-ray doesn't hurt you, a bunch throughout your life or all at once can damage your tissues enough to cause health problems. And if that weren't complicated enough, there are different types of ionizing radiation: alpha, beta, gamma, and X-rays. Those are listed in increasing energy levels. Alpha radiation is the slower big fella. It can't really penetrate your body, but it's essentially a handful of protons and neutrons. Beta is basically a tiny, fast-moving electron. It can penetrate your body, but not some denser materials like aluminum. Then there's gamma radiation, which is just pure energy, moving super fast. It's so small, it can pass between your cells, but if it hits your DNA, it's gonna mess you up. Though it won't make you green and invulnerable. In fact, gamma ray energy is so high it can pass through you, aluminum, concrete, though not lead. It's too dense. X-rays are kind of like gamma rays, but lower energy. In the end, you probably don't have to worry a lot about ionizing radiation. UV rays can damage DNA over time, so wear sunscreen, but X-rays are highly regulated, and hopefully you haven't spent too much time near unbridled nuclear reactions or exposed yourself to cosmic rays. But most radiation is just regular non-ionizing stuff. Heck, even humans emit infrared radiation in the form of heat, and some ionizing radiation that we absorb from food like bananas. It's everywhere, and though some of it can damage you, it's not all bad. What if you lived in a place surrounded by radiation? You know, if it was in the earth and the water and up in the sky, animals living around Chernobyl survive in that environment every day. Watch as Animal Planet presents the world premiere of Life After Chernobyl, Tuesday, April 26th at 10, 9 Central. How do you guys feel about radiation now? Does more knowledge help alleviate your fears of it? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get all the D News that's fit to print, and we'll see you next time.